to April. So this video is for career and money in April for your rising sign specifically. You can watch it for your sun sign or any other part of your chart, but this video right here is going to tell you why you should be watching for your rising sign specifically, especially in my readings, but basically every reading concerning career and money. The general readings are right here, and that's what they look like if you want to figure out what's going on, overall themes for your sun sign. And then we've got our love readings that are coming up soon. So if you like these videos at all, please give them a thumbs up and subscribe so you know when the new ones are coming out. Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you're alerted. Okay, so this month, what is going on in career and money? What does it look like in general is theme number one. Number two, what do we have to look forward to? Number three, what's going to be your biggest annoyance? Number four, what do we need to look more closely at? And then number five, the general advice and guidance for the month of April. Let's get started. Capricorn, what do career and money look like for you generally? They're like, awesome. This is a month where you really get to focus on what it is that you love. Okay, so even if your money situation is a little bit messed up because you're not able to go to work, well, then you have more time at home to focus on the things that you love. And sometimes those love things can slowly but surely turn into careers for you or whatever. So they say it's a slow money month, but it's actually a good month because it raises your vibration. Because when we're at a vibration level of love or above, then it's easier for us to attract money, where people might just gift it to us and things like that. So it's kind of an answer, not answer. So I'm going to ask the question again. What does career look like for you in general? And so they're saying for those of you who are still working right now in this coronavirus stuff, you'll continue to do so. But for the rest of you, it's kind of like everything's going to be the way that it's already been for you. They say they want you to think about what is it that you wish for and hope for? All of these little stars here, okay? Because those are going to culminate into something bigger and beautiful and more bright for you in the future. You're able to manifest those if you're able to like actually sit down and write down, what is it that I want for my life? They're saying those of you who get kind of bummed out and sad that you can't like go see your friends and things like that, that's going to kind of lower your vibrational energy, which doesn't actually help you. Now, as far as money goes, they're saying, hey, this is a month for Capricorns to really manifest funds into their life. So that might come in the form of not actually people or the government or whatever giving you money. It could come in the form of discounts. So they're saying manifest what it is that you want. This is an important time to write down what your needs are and to actually put them out into the universe. This is a good form of self-care, actually. And they say make a consistent practice of doing that. That's very important for you. Because you will and you can get what you want on top of something bigger than that. You know, if you don't want to pay your rent this month, you say, I want a free month of rent. Maybe your landlord is feeling, particularly guilty given the situation, and they have a big heart and they just say, no, you know, everybody's not going to pay their rent this month. There's who knows? But they're saying, you know, because this is better done, I think, this month in particular with coronavirus stuff on an individual basis. But for overall, most Capricorns, Capricorn risings, this is going to be the situation for you that you're in a very powerful manifestation state. So be super conscious of what it is that you're putting out into the universe. What is it that you desire? What is it that you expect? What is it that you want? And focus on that because you can have it, okay? So what do you have to look forward to? They're saying getting back to hard work, but in a way that you get to control more of what you put into it. You know, like a very sustained and controlled effort. It's like methodical and it's very orderly. They're saying this is gonna give you confidence. For you, you need to have like very strong and rigid routines in order to feel successful and to feel like you're making progress. So if you don't have written goals, that's gonna be very important for you to figure out what those are, because you can and will achieve them, and that's something to look forward to. And like I said, you could be achieving more than you even thought you were capable of. So what's going to be your biggest annoyance this month? Well, for those of you who choose to focus on what's going wrong and what's bumming you out instead of what's still pretty okay for you, you're going to just kind of sink in that energy and you're going to stay there. And I know it's annoying when people say happiness is a choice, but to some degree it sort of is, because there are different things that you can do in order to start shifting your vibration, and then slowly over time it gets better, right? One stupid example is smiling a lot, even if you're not happy, because your psychology follows your physiology. You can't help but feel a little better if you do that in the mirror for like 5 minutes straight, which is an excessive amount of time, but it does raise your vibration, even if it's just because you're laughing at yourself and how stupid this seems, okay? Because laughter also raises your vibration. So what do you need to look more closely at was the question. And they're like, look more closely at your successes and how other people praise you. What do they say that you're good at? What do they give you credit for? And feel really gracious and accepting and appreciative of that. And then you can use that to your advantage. You can even just use it to fulfill your happiness. It's not arrogant to also kind of tout your own praise to some degree because other people agree with it, right? And I actually just today did a reading for somebody where they were looking to kind of figure out where do they focus their energy and career. And that's what they said. It was in confidence. And I gave the example that, let's say, for example, you were going to have a surgery and the doctor said, you know, I've done a lot of these. I mean, I could be better at it. I'm not an expert. There are people who are better, but I'm pretty good at these. Pretty good success rate and outcome versus the doctor who says, I am the best at these. People love my outcomes. This is, you know, what I love to do. I'm amazing at this surgery. Even despite whatever the actual outcomes are, patient satisfaction and like actual health and results, you're going to trust that second doctor more because he's putting out there a confidence and then you feel like that's actually true, right? And you feel better, more confident about the decision that you're making that way. Does that make sense? And so there is a need for you to sort of express that and feel jubilant and joyful within it. So what is the general guidance or advice for you this month in career and then in money? In career, they're like, sometimes shit happens and it's not fair and it sucks, but like try to find an emotional balance surrounding that between how we feel about it and then the practical reality of things. Because, I mean, we can't control the situation either way. And so whatever is going on for you, whether it's coronavirus related or it isn't, it's like getting upset about it isn't going to change the outcome. It's just going to make you feel worse. And why do we want to feel worse? You know, we can take this time and just feel as okay as we can feel. We want to keep our vibration high to attract those things that we want in our life. Now, as far as money goes, they're saying be super organized with your money. If you don't have a budget, figure that out, like really plan that out, get super clear and organized on what your financial goals and things like that are, because positive things can happen for you and they'll just like, boom, come out of nowhere overnight if we do that. And if we're feeling like we're super in control of our money, then therefore we are, okay? So that is April and I'll see you in May.